We'll be right back. insieme abbiamo dato una lista per una sopra. E la mia risposta è sempre il fatto che non entrano, che la sua attività di medico non sa che non è più quello, o se non è più quello, si faccia in una tentata di medico. In caso di scoprire di sé, come ottimo non è quello che io spesso faccio sulla mia strada, e poi ci presto.
We'll be right back. Thank you. Sometimes I'm alone, sitting on my very own, trying to find a simple kind of blue. And I would like to know why the doozer moved me so, doing all the things that doozers do. Why?
Take real action, or millions will die.
I won't go! We'll be right back. Steve on the Relapse Podcast. I'm joined today with Parker Chandler, the bassist of Windhand. How you doing today, man?
Doing pretty good, all things considered.
I want to thank you in advance for taking the time to be on the podcast with me today.
For sure.
And it's a very exciting year for Windhand. You have your new album, Grief's Inferno Flower, coming out in just a few weeks. How has this album been comparing to Soma?
I don't know. It's hard to say. You know, it's not out yet, so we haven't seen a lot of honest reactions to it. It's pretty cool for, you know, us.
You have a few singles out so far, and you have a tour coming up as well. So do you plan to play anything other than these two songs on the new tour?
Yeah, we'll probably play like one or two more.
That tour, of course, will be headlining. You're going to be starting in October in the New York date, going all the way through November. And just going back to the album, how for you personally have you decided to do any new things for this album?
With Soma, I came in like maybe halfway through the writing process when I actually joined the band. And that was written over years and years. So this one, I had a little bit more time to actually sit down and focus because I was actually a part of the writing process. And sort of put my own little bass fills on it and stuff.
So this time around, you really got to have the full experience behind it.
Yeah, I was much more involved this time around.
How long did it take to write this album? Because you were saying for Soma, it was quite a while.
Yeah, this one, once we really, like, hunkered down, yeah, I think we knocked it out in about 3 months, and we added, like, an extra practice day, went practice as many times as we could.
Is this going to be the first tour when the new album comes out, or have you guys been doing anything recently?
We did, like, a couple shows with Sleep back in May, and then we did a run up to Canada last month. But aside from that, this is the first time we're taking like a bulk of the new material on the road.
As well as with Windhand, you also balance playing in Cough, both of which are Relapse bands. So being so involved with the label, what does it mean to be part of this history?
It's pretty cool. You know, like back when Cough got on board, they were, you know, a little bit hesitant to put out, double LP and stuff like that, it seems. And now, you know, I think since vinyl and just sort of like the slower, heavier side of things has picked up, you know, it's sort of like we're growing together.
You make a good point about that. If you look the past few years, there's, of course, the very big vinyl craze that has been happening again. A lot of labels are reprinting, creating a lot of cool designs on the actual vinyl itself. And then you have a lot of emergence, I guess you could say, of all these doomier and sludgier bands. What do you think it is that really had a lot of this underground creating?
I mean, honestly, I think the internet has done a lot to sort of bring, you know, like more obscure genres to the forefront. So, yeah, I mean, you know, I feel like, and especially with, as shitty as it is, like the illegal downloading thing, you know, there's not a lot of risk involved in people, like, sort of exploring new music. And, you know, from that, you get into, like, the free album streams that a lot of people have been doing to sort of combat the legal downloads.
Usually about a week or so before, you'll have a certain blog or press will stream the whole album. And on top of the illegal downloading, which, honestly, in 2015, you can't really stop somebody from doing it. So do you think this actually benefits, besides for creating an exposure?
I think so. You know, being in the position we're in, you know, it's not like we're making a living, you know, off of doing the music thing solely. And it's kind of hard to say how much it really hurts the amount of royalties that we see. But what it does do is these people, you know, they'll steal the stuff off the internet, but they'll come see us in person, buy merchandise or buy the vinyl and stuff. And, you know, it works out pretty well for us in that regard.
At the end of the day, nothing really beats that true experience of seeing the people coming out, playing in front of a nice-sized crowd and having a good reaction to your set. Playing with Windhand and Cough, do you notice a comparison between some of the crowds, like a bit of an overlaps, or are they completely different shows?
I think it's a lot of the same fans. There's sort of a weird write-up about our last show in Boston where they pointed out that there was an abnormal number of women out at a metal show, which I think, I don't know, I don't really ever look around and notice things like that.
You're in the heat of the moment at the time.
Yeah, you know, trying to drink a beer.
But that's cool, though, because metal is usually a very male predominant, so that's good publicity to have that women are taking a very big interest in your music.
Yeah, I think it worked for the Beatles.
Yeah, that's very true. For someone that may not be familiar with doom metal, how would you possibly describe a way for them to get into it?
Check out, you know, Black Sabbath, St. Vitus, all the sort of classic stuff, and then you can go from there.
Yeah.
All of the natural progression, so to speak.
Everybody that really set the foundation for things.
Yeah, yeah. Of course, you know, Pentagram, if you want to give Relapse a shout-out.
Shout-out to Pentagram. When writing for both Windhand and Cough, I know for Cough you do the vocals as well.
Uh-huh.
So do you ever have that itch to do anything for Windhand?
Not really. You know, I try to keep them fairly separate. Dorothea has, like, you know, said things before, but I don't know. I don't really have much of a desire. If she's writing a song about something else, it doesn't really mean anything to me.
Is there any future work for Coffin planned?
Oh, that's actually what we're doing right now, is loading up my van with Garrett's recording equipment. We're going to drive out to the country and record a new record.
Right before the new Windhand tour. It's a perfect way to spend the time.
Yeah, we're going to record a new record, and I'm going to do a Windhand tour and sort of come back to the Cough thing later. New music will be out, at least.
2016?
Yeah, it'll probably be springtime or early 2016.
What is the biggest piece of advice you would give to somebody that wants to multitask with multiple bands?
Find good people. That's, you know, I get along with all 8 of my fellow band members, and, you know, there's ups and downs and everything, but in the end, we're like 2 families with a tangent member.
Just trying to find ways to accommodate to both.
Yeah. You know, David from Cough had a kid, so it sort of eased tensions there, because now there's just, you know, so much stuff that we're just not able to do.
Which gives you more time for Windhand?
Yeah.
Windhand's new album, Grief's Inferno Flower, set to release September 18th. See them on tour with Denava and Monolord starting in October.
All right, so this is Kripke off of our new album, Grief's Inferno Flower. I picked it because it's a little bit of a departure from what we normally do. I think we sort of stepped outside of our comfort zone for the note progression and the overall feel of the song. The next one is Shepherd's Crook off of our split with my other band, Cough. Sort of an older song that we had and revamped it for the use of the split, and we haven't played it since we recorded it.
Are you guys going to play it this time around?
I don't know. We've talked about it, and like people have asked, but we just haven't. I don't know, you know, like we were writing an album and stuff, and we sort of like sometimes we'll dip into older songs, but we have not made any plans to do it this run coming up.
So maybe one day. I have to ask, how is it recording a split with yourself?
It was cool. It is, you know, two very different environments, but it was a lot of fun.
We'll be right back.
This is Acid Witch off the deluxe version of Ritual Abuse. This kind of an older song that we had that we didn't necessarily feel like it really belonged on the album. Relapse said we could put it on the deluxe version on iTunes and also on the vinyl version of Ritual Abuse.
Magic acid child, walk to your grave.
Sleep by Face Down and Shit. And this is Ryan from Windhand's older band, which is also on Relapse. And this song just sort of lyrically, just like the negativity that you can feel coming out of this track is ridiculous. So it's always sort of stuck with me as one of the favorites, and I feel fortunate to be able to play music with them. We'll do Four Teeth by our friends True Widow from Dallas, Texas. Sort of a more laid-back, a little bit of a shoegazy thing going on. I just love this song. It's been stuck in my head ever since I heard it. And now it'll be in yours.
Oh,
up next is The Finality by Wake off of Voices of Omens. Also, you know, CT and Reed, good friends of ours. And Voices of Omens, when that came out, I think somebody in our practice space gave me a like promo copy of it. And, you know, I was familiar with Wake. I'd seen them before, but this album sort of put them in a different place as far as I'm concerned. I thought everything, the production and the finality, always stuck out to me.
Oh,
Do you have any final words for your fans out there, Parker?
I hope you enjoyed listening to this thing, and we'll see you guys in October or November.